Phoenix magazine is out today, featuring top doctors in the valley, as well as some of the new and cutting-edge medical trends. And one of those procedures, certainly getting a lot of attention, maybe raising eyebrows around our station, is the eyebrow transplant. Yes, you heard me right. So Kim is live with a valley doctor specializing in this unique treatment. Kim.
Good morning to you, Olivia. This is a brand new procedure. I've got to tell you, I was kind of shocked when I heard eyebrow transplants, but it's something that's being highlighted within Phoenix Magazine's top docs issues. So I have Craig here with us this morning from Phoenix Magazine. Tell us a little bit about this issue. You guys highlight some of the best doctors around the valley.
Absolutely. It's our biggest issue of the year, and it's a serious issue. Healthcare is serious, so, you know, it's a serious issue. It's 400 pages, but we always find opportunities for fun things to bring into the magazine, you know, I guess you'd say the lighter side of healthcare, and we thought eyebrow restoration definitely fit the bill.
Well, eyebrows are so popular.
I'm shocked. Mm-hmm. I had no idea. It's like a trending cosmetic, you know, beauty value. So
everyone wants them the fuller. I feel like they give a more youthful appearance. So this was something very interesting to highlight. So let's come inside here, and we have Dr. Andrew Wolin with us, who actually does eyebrow transplants. We also have Adrian, who is a patient who is having eyebrow transplants done. Good morning to you.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
I am fantastic. So this is incredibly interesting. Give me the backstory. How does this work?
Backstory is that these procedures are permanent, and what we do is we take a little bit of hair utilizing a specific machine that takes individual follicles with individual shafts, and then we figure what exactly the patient really wants in terms of their shape. Everybody wants something slightly different. Adrian did not want too big of an arch, and we pretty much draw it based on certain principles, but bottom line is it's what the patient really wants. So we extend the brow to where it normally would be, and for most people it's the outer corner of the eye from the corner of the nose, but it's variable. You can do whatever, and you can also improve the thickness of the brow medially. The hair is taken out, and then it is planted individually. Individual hairs are planted, and it's forever. It's permanent, and this is what you get forever. Procedure takes a couple hours to do, but it's done under a local anesthetic, and it works extremely well.
So do you only have one application done? Do you have to come back multiple times as you would with microblading, per se?
No, this is not a temporary putting tattoo in or putting any kind of pigment in. This is your own hair, and no, you do not have to come back. Usually about 250 hairs are utilized on each side, and that does a very nice job, and the patients are extremely happy with that.
So how does this grow? Do your eyebrows continue to grow like your head hair?
Yeah, this is the only issue with it, that you have to train the shafts. Once they start growing, you put them in on specific angles. So the stuff that's put in, the hair follicles, that's put in on the inside kind of goes more vertical. And then as you go out, they kind of crisscross. But then you have to train them to do that, because obviously they're from the back, and from the hair in the back is not the same as the hair on your brow. But you can train them so that they have a very nice flow. They look very natural, and it's a very doable thing.
So women, we pluck our eyebrows, we wax our eyebrows. What if we plucked out or waxed out the follicle? Would it be gone?
That would not be a good thing.
Yeah.
No. After you do this, the follicle is the little machine, the little engine that produces the shafts. And so you do not want to pluck them out. The idea here is that you only put the hair follicles where you want it to aesthetically go. You don't start putting it places and then destroy it. The idea here is this is a permanent change. We did on Adrian, we did this all, actually, this whole portion of her up here is all also grafted hair, because she was losing a lot of hair. So she did this over a year ago, and she's got great hair at the top. So she came in and said, "What about my brows? What do you think?" I said, "Great."
Very quickly, how much does this procedure run for, roughly?
It starts at about $4,000 to do the procedure. It's a full day of artistic and harvesting, and that's about the average price, really, at about $4,000.
How can folks get in touch with you?
They can call my office at 480-945-8440. They can go on my website at awolin.com is the easiest way to get on. And through that, the consultations are no cost, and we can tell you whether or not you're a candidate, and that's how it runs.
Dr. Wolin, thank you so much. Adrian, thank you so much. And if you'd like more information on some of the great doctors around the valley, you can check out Phoenix Magazine's Top Docs issue.
What'll they think of next? I love that. That's fascinating, Kim. Thank you.